answer. And Paul said, take it away from me. Some of you may be right there right now. God, please save my marriage. God, please take away this pain. Take away my baby's pain. God, help me find a job so that I can support my family. Whatever it is, you're praying, you're pleading. This is what Paul did. He didn't have any answers. He had nowhere to go except to God. God, I trust you. I beseech you. Please take this away. I'm only asking you to do what you've done through me. You've done it this time. You've seen me answer. I've seen you answer prayer by me praying for people. I've seen you do this and do that in my life. And God, all I'm asking you to do right now is to help me. Maybe he said, I can serve you more effectively if you do this. God said to Paul, he said, my grace. Hallelujah. My grace is sufficient for you. For my power is made perfect when you're weak. God said, no. Not this one. Paul is sufficient. What's that mean? What grace? Isn't grace what brings forgiveness of sin? What is grace? Godly, God freely extends himself, his favor, his grace, reaching, inclining to people. Why? Because he is at their disposal to bless them and to be near them. It's the learning in God. It's the, here I am for you. God wants to reveal himself to you. God wants you to know he will reveal and be with you in the present time of help. He is always there. He will never leave, regardless of what you're going through. You and God can handle anything. Oh, hallelujah. Would you just lift your hands and worship the Lord right now? Sometimes we want what we want. He said, on the other hand, we tend to say, God, this is what I need. This is what I want. God's not a genie in the bottle. He doesn't do what we want. If you do this, then I'll have what I need. God said, no, this is not what you need. In this case, he said, I am what you need. I am sufficient. My grace is what you need. Hang on to me. With the learning and presence of God, I can do what I want. You have to wait on God to do his will. It's God's grace. Some of you have made it where you are today. I don't know. I received this special grace form. I don't have one to give you today. How in the world are you surviving what you're doing? Well, I'm not really sure. It's the grace of God. It's the present God. And he's enough to take care of all our needs. Prayer isn't just about getting in our way. Sometimes it's surrendering ourselves to God. We are continually speaking after God's presence and power. God is seeking you. God, even if you don't do this for me, I'm going to still trust you. I've seen people that get sick and not live for God anymore. They got mad at God. I've seen people, Brother Brock, that's told me I didn't come to church, and I don't come to church because I'm mad at God. He took my husband. He took my my wife. He took my children. I'm upset with him. I don't understand it. Everything works to the good of those that love the Lord. You may not understand, but he works to help you. When he says no, accept it and go on. Has anybody here ever been told no since you've been a child of God? It's going to happen to you. Sometimes the things we want is not the best for what he wants us to have. You may lose your job tomorrow, but if you stay in the will of God, he'll give you a better one down the road. That's the way he is. He loves you, and if you love him, you will ask for his continuance to get in his will. Never hit by. When we get to the active, saying, Lord, I don't understand why. I don't understand why things are going on. But even if you never touch me, and even if I fail, which you won't, I'm going to serve you. Will trust you. When everything fails in my life and nothing goes right. When they take the car, when there's no food in the pantry, when the electric is cut off and the water doesn't run anymore. When the doctor said, I've done all I can do, I know nothing else to do. There's one more source, and his name is Jesus. When everything fails, when everybody's washed out, and you get the doctors just shaking their head and itching their head and don't know what to do, there's a man by the name of Dr. Jesus that can cure all things in this world.
In your life will never be the same.
There's only
one way to touch.
One way. It's tell him, son.
Just believe.
Just believe.
When you call.
When you call. Somebody worship God.
Touching Jesus is all that matters. In your life will never be the same.
Hallelujah.
There's
only one way.
One way.
Not the Baptist way, the Church of God way, or Jehovah's Witness way. Just believe. When they call on his name, touch him. We're believing Jesus. Would you just worship him real right now? Would you just worship him? Would you just worship him? You got a need. Why don't you reach up? Why don't you say, Lord, I got a need. I believe what that pastor has preached, and I just want to lift my hand, and I want to let you know, Father, I need that hand. Hallelujah. Would you stand all over the building?
Matters.
Hallelujah.
In your life,
oh, if you live God. Said it's over. My God, be back tonight. Be back tonight and be here and come and trust the Lord. And I believe God still answers prayer. Sister Alice has got to go tomorrow to
hospital in Spartanburg, doctor's office. Please pray that they'll find out exactly what this is all about. He knows. We may not know, but he does. He knows. Say a prayer for us. We'll be there at 10:30 in the morning. Say a prayer. Hold on. Touch. And he will. He will in his own time. I thought about Brother Byron this morning. He came in. He said, I've been sort of down. I believe he said 11 years ago. Brother Byron, 11 years ago, he got hurt. They put him in a wheelchair. He wasn't born that way. He was in an accident on a go-kart, racing go-kart. You wouldn't think that would make anybody have to go to a wheelchair. But you know what? I thank the Lord every day for him because he's accepted the way he is. He'll make jokes about it. I never will forget. Jamie was moving him one day and one chair to the other, and I never have forgiven him for that. But Byron was hollering. He said, oh, Jamie, I'm hurt. Don't you hurt me. I said, Jamie, well, wait a minute, he's hurt. That nut goes to life. I said, what do you like me? He said, I ain't got no feeling in my legs. Thank God for people that can laugh about it like that. Amen. Will you stand now? Thank you for coming. Father, thank you for this time of worship, Lord God, for the way you work and minister in our hearts and lives today, Father. Thank you, Lord God, for the way that you minister. And Father, we just ask that you touch and guide each one of us, Father, in a very special way. In Jesus Christ's precious name. Amen.
Huh?
Should I know
what? Oh, yeah.
We got to talk about you.